Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another exciting, wondrous Propagandacast. With me, your host, Imperial Dane. We'll be watching here as Heisenberg fights for the Soviet Union. And the 20th Tank Corps going up against Isundil of the 23rd Panzer Division. Achtung! We'll be watching him with Festung Support, Spearhead and Joint Operations. Versus Heisenberg's Guard Motor, Mechanized and Shock Rifle. There clearly seems to be an emphasis on Guard's Riflemen being available right here for good old Heisenberg. Of course, the question is, what will he in the end choose? Also, the vehicle seems to be abundantly awesome. Available as well. Very handy and powerful ability. But back here to Isundil. Starting out with some Grenadier, following up with a Maschinengewehr. Ein schweres Maschinengewehr, 42. Points there being secured. Spreading out here so far, nice, and actually going for a two conscript strike, and then quickly doubling back for the special rifle command, whatever could Heisenberg be brewing. We shall find out then, following up with Grenadiers. So two Grenadiers, MD, just sort of the order in which he gets them is going to be interesting. Also noting, he's very much focused on the west-hand side. He's ignoring the other side of the road so far. It's definitely an interesting here approach to the map. But as again, we are seeing the Russian players basically just spreading over the map like a vast red tide. Pioneers here. Pioneers incoming under fire, MG-42 moving up. Conscripts holding up here behind an old Panierwagen, as was known. Well, at least the Germans called it that. They also used it quite a bit as well for all their horse-driven units. Or horse-carted. Now he's engaged by conscripts. Pioneers moving in. MG-42 here, interesting enough. Rather finding himself with a bit of a blind, but also interesting MG-42 positioning actually using this shack. That's not to say it's necessarily all bad, because unlike this building which can actually be crept up on, this one's got reasonable cover of everything around here, but can't be so easily snuck up on. So it's not exactly bad, but it's pretty unusual. Pretty unusual. Pioneers are getting blasted by the conscript grenadiers, quickly following up here. Grenadiere leading survey for Deutschland. And then following up with a mortar, two grenadiers, MG mortar. What will we be going for next? Special Rifle Command so far revealing nothing, but there we go. The Strafniki arriving. Vicious criminals, as they are mentioned. Convicted of such barbarous crimes as accountancy. And knowing which way the pointy end of a bayonet goes. Well, not that, that's just me being silly. Can't be silly once in a while, then you can't. The enemy has made contact. But conscript going in here, Isundil does need to be a bit careful. I mean, he's leaving a bit of a gap here, which Heisenberg is quite nicely exploring so far. Three grenadier squads. Also, grenadiers have been engaged by the Strafniki with SVT-40s. The Soviet semi-automatic rifle of choice. Upgraded with a flamethrower as well. Lovely. Grenadiers need to pull back. The Strafniki are moving in with murderous intent in their hearts. Mortar firing away. Mortar on firing away. Also note, the Germans also make use of penal troops. It's just that you actually remember the Russians for using them, but the Germans actually make quite use of them as well throughout the war. So, a little fun fact there as well. Strafniki there run off. Took a bit of damage then, of course, caught in the crosshairs of the MG-42. And mines going up there. Nice mining, though. Usually you want to sort of, you know, not have the opponent see it. Also losing a squad. Damn, poor luck there, Isundil. But still, mining, good. Opponent spotting your mining, less good. Again, usually consider a mine like a Christmas present. You don't want the other one, you know, to know about it and ruin the surprise. Unlike Christmas presents, I mean, you actually expect it to blow up in their faces. Usually I don't think you expect that with Christmas presents. At least that's not how we do it in our house. And I hope that stays that way. But penal troops advancing here. Another Strafe Nikki unit here arriving. Lovely, lovely. Fresh pioneers arriving behind holding. He has checked up. Consuls here, they need to get into cover or get the hell out of there. In particular with that mortar firing away as well. Slinging 8cm mortar rounds all over the place. Strafniki holding up here nicely in light cover versus the Grenadiers. Definitely able to lay down about as much fire as they can. More mortar fire. In fact, we've seen slow pullback here. Troops here. Strafniki not looking to be actually merged with. Looks like he's actually enforcing them. Interesting. Usually you'd see a player merge his conscripts with the Strafniki, thus making it a bit cheaper to overall reinforce them. Pioneers there go, like to make a nice company going up. Grenadier moving out.
Motherland has given us new weapons.
Also, the SVT 40 was actually the sort of base of the Soviet infantry doctrine, which in some regards actually had some similarities to the Americans, that is, they put an emphasis on the rifle. The difference was they basically couldn't produce enough of them to equip everyone, unlike the Americans could with their M1 Garand. So the SVT 40 was sort of more handed out on our other bases, basically. For some, you had naval infantry assembled from the crews and whatnot of ships fighting down in Sevastopol, fully equipped with SVT 40s, but you know, the average Soviet infantry MRLs couldn't see that many of them, so little fun fact there. The primary rifle was still the venerable Moser Nagant. Strafniki here, though, suffering a bit under the mortar. The mortar, though, is not doing so much kills. Needs to pull back, or at least towards the MD-40. Also, knowing victory point here has not been secured by Isundil. He could consider scout car to help dealing with some of the infantry here. A quick scout car with some machine gun fire could certainly cause a bit of a headache for Heisenberg, Strafniki, and Conscript Niki.
Grenadiers here!
Panzer Grenadiers are also an option. The Panzer Grenadier moving ahead here. Mortar crew suffering loss, but there go the MD42 raking the Strafniki, killing quite a few of them.
Our lines of supply are disrupted.
Grenadiers moving up. Counter-attacking the Soviet infantry, slightly pushing them back. No additional mines so far from Heisenberg, and we're seeing here a rather bold move for an early Tanguy battalion command here from Heisenberg. It'll be interesting. Also, lots of light machine guns for Isundil's Grenadiere. Certainly increasing the amount of firepower there available for them as well. Quick rifle from there, forcing back the Strafniki. Conscripts holding out. They're still behind some of the haystacks. Troops here out in the open. More rifle grenades. And there we go, not really good position in the Strafniki, really taking it out on the Grenadiers. And there we go, quickly merging with them before retreating the rest of the squad. Nice move there, actually, realizing he can not get some that much model of the conscripts, instead just opting to reinforce the penal troops. Well played there, nice maneuver. Tank of Ibatan command standing up. I think that Isundil needs to actually move about the MD42, but actually get a lot wider than he actually used to support his infantry. That there is a bit covered under the Propagandacast layer, but you know, not the best usage of the MD42, I have to say. Hardly the most effective and proven choice. Panzer Abwehrkanone rolling out here soon for Isundil. Definitely not going to be a bad idea, since there likely will be Soviet armor rolling out soon.
The PEC gun is ready for orders.
Minesweeper engineers, Heisenberg's definitely not taking any chances with Isundil. Getting up minesweepers just in case the bastard has been laying up mines, though so far no mines from Isundil, no S mines, no Teller mines. Or Regal mines, though that rarely happens. We are seeing he's gone for Spearhead Doctrine. No sign, though, of a mortar half-tech, which could be a nice little extra addition. Grenadier versus the Strafniki. Two Grenadier squads with MG42s. Definitely not looking good there for the Strafniki, but they managed to get around. But there we go, more countries rushing in, more Strafniki. Will the Grenadiers hold out against this vicious Soviet assault? Nope, looks like they did not. Conscripts, or Strafniki take up position here, and they're burning right at the MD42. Nice, nice, nice. Although there's a mortar nearby which could bombard them. Then again, Russian infantry is pushing in. Engagement over here on the right flank. Conscripts pushing back the Grenadiers. Pioneers rather far ahead. And there we go. T-34-76 pushing ahead through the center. Barging its way through the harvest of, I know, yesterday, I know. Lots of fire here, MG Fire 2 in danger of getting cleared out. Not good right there, lots of flame prop for the Strafniki, definitely increasing their firepower at all. There you go, getting a bit too close to the machine gun bunker. MG 42 firing frei. Like a butterfly. Except they usually don't go fire frei.
Reinforcements complete!
And what is this? Ooh, laying down some flare trip mines. Cheeky, cheeky.
Pack loaded for Panzer.
Support armor core going up here. Ready to supply the 23rd Panzer Division with some Panzers. Troops moving ahead there. Coming under fire. T-34 providing nice fire support there with the 76mm gun. Strafniki being pushed back. With rather unfortunate losses to follow. And there we go, the support armor coils up. He could go for the Storm Gestütz right now, though likely he's going to go for the Panther 4, which is a favorite of many players. Certainly it is the safe choice, or at least I'll also say the Stuga's safe choice, but overall, in some regards, probably a bit safer again due to the fact it has a turret and also more health. So, of course, there is that. But there we go, Strafniki getting away. They have managed to secure the victory points. Nice play around those, in fact. Displaying nice mobility in fighting against Isundil here, Mr. Heisenberg, and popping over to him, in fact. No doctrine as of yet. No doctrine. Flame. That's a bit surprising.
We have the point.
Standing out here having a bit of fun. Keeping his T-34 repaired. Also, he's actually got two combat engine squad. More mines up as well. Good, good. Not really good there for the MD-42 to be there with the T-34 firing away. Panzer Abwehrkanone, though, blasting his back in return. And there go veterans button mines there again. Be a bit careful about how you place your mines. Don't do straight too obvious. Never mind under the arc of fire of the mortar, in which case, you know, you might find yourself, you know, oh look comrades, we have finished mine. Oh look, high explosives that are about to set off the mine arriving from above, ensuring we have no chance of surviving. Shit.
Supply sector under attack.
And there you go, the Panzerkampfwagen 4, workhorse of the Panzerwaffe arriving for Isundil. Already equipped with a pencil mounted machine gun. Then it is getting pushed back here by a nice push here, and again, centre and support units are very much unguarded. Perhaps he's hoping the MD-42 in the shed can turn things around, and there we go, suppressing. Panzerkampfwagen 4 rolling ahead, stopping up, good, ensuring it won't get so much gas on its shots. Right now, he actually has a chance of actually leading a counter-attack against Heisenberg with his Panzer IV. As long as he keeps producing his reported, he should in fact be able to lead a reasonably, again, nice counter-attack. There we go, nice hit. Two Bolsheviks dead. Second T-34 arriving. And constant and, you know, rather slightly obsessive tech repairs, but that is good, that is good, ensuring it's always repaired, even the slightest issue fixed swiftly and without complaint. Flank attempt here being conducted by a few gunners. Panzer 4 moving up, supporting the infantry's advance. Lovely, lovely. Cartoons, you need to be careful. Panzer 4 firing away, high explosive shields ringing across the battlefield, and Heisenberg's second T-34 arrives.
We are losing territory.
He's about to be caught in a bit of a bind there. Nice flanking hit there on the Panzer 4s. Also, not quickly pulling back, and again, looks like he's about to repair once more. Other T-34 moving up, and he needs to be careful. Forsicht, Forsicht. Also looks like he's about to repair, but again, be careful about close to the front line like that. Two Panzer IVs quickly moving about, feeding back and forth. Also, he's got minesweepers up. Good, good, he hasn't seen any, I think, or at least experienced them or hit them, but still, he's actually getting it. Good, good, absolutely splendid. That's thinking ahead, that's actually thinking that your opponent is a bastard who knows how to play the game. Good, excellent. T-34 T-34 here, heavily damaged. Other T-34, but also Veterans one though. This one's definitely too close to the front line. He needs to pull back. Also, he needs to get both engineer squads to work on this right away. Panzer IV not doing so well, but looks like he doesn't quite have the sufficient number of pioneers to expedite that repair. Which is a bit unfortunate. Go, get to work on the other. There we go. Both pioneer squads, engineer squads to work on that. Penal troops moving in, but are immediately met with some unfriendly attention from the Panzerkampfwagen. Mortar continues to fire away with impunity. Oh, careful, careful, careful! Heisenberg quickly pushing ahead again, opting to see if he can't punish his opponent further, and also probably get a grasp of how the state of his tank is, which again notes him he probably has some time before that Panzer IV returns to the battlefield, or at least that is one assumption he could make. Considering again he knew he took down some health, and now again all this time has passed and he's still rushing, he hasn't seen a lot of repairs.
Enemy contact!
Of course there's still the Pack 40, but that needs to be positioned a bit better. I would actually recommend you don't try so much here, but actually up here where again there's more room for it to maneuver in, and also a bit more or less blocking its path. Also less of a choke point here. Panzer is now joining in. Pack 40 gets off a hit there on the T-34. Could see some mines over here that would actually benefit Mr. Heisenberg. And there you go, Veterans of the Grenadiere. There we go, T-34 moving ahead. Need to be careful here, Pack needs to be able to support it again. This is a bit dangerous, but looks like there we go. Getting off a nice hit on the T-34. Almost getting, in fact, of the T-34 blasting right the Grenadiers out on the hill, or in the middle of everything. And again, more pioneers. This is going to take too long with that Panzer IV.
Keep your head down. Not ready to be used.
Penal troops moving ahead there. MD-42 might be able to open up. There we go. Penal troops arriving straight in front of it, but no. Satchel charge. MD-42, can he get it out of there? Oh, again. Not so good use of that MD-42. I do feel it was a shame, and he could have made much better use out of that MD-42. So that was definitely not so strongly handled right there by Isundil. Grenadiers, aber they need to retreat zu verlassen die Stellungen. He might even end up losing them. He's not careful in position. Now they occupy position in the building, fighting from the ruins of the farmhouse and using the flamethrower from the roof. Veterans one for the Panzerkampfwagen 4. T-34 close to Veterans 2 as well. And these Trafniki now need to get out of there, actually. They're taking a lot of shots as well. Not looking too good there. Oh! Bit too slow there, Heisenberg. And time for the mid-game analysis. Current situation is territory largely in the advantage of Heisenberg, though he's just suffered some nasty flaws. He's actually quick to replace with another penal battalion. Good job there. Thumbs up to Heisenberg. Tanks, you know, looking reasonably alright. He's definitely got the armoured numerical advantage. Two T-34s will beat a Panzer IV unless you're really cocking it up or it's much more veteran than you are. In fact, he's getting close to having this T-34 Veteran T2, which actually means it does more damage, aims better, and will, you know, I believe he's actually moves the turrets faster, but also, you know, has a higher rate of fire. So that's actually going to be a rather potent little thing if Isundil here is not careful. Pack 40 going to need healing and reinforcement, but overall, I mean, more mines also mining up some of the flanks, and also this bit here would do a lot, you know, to sort of slow up what sort of damage Mr. Isundil can do, and also sort of inflict more damage upon him as he's actually trying to move into enemy territory. He might also want to consider getting either a sniper or perhaps a scout card to sort of add another element to his force. A half tank could also be good to sort of keep frontline reinforcements up, or a T-70. And another way to sort of deal with sort of flanking harassments instead of mines. He also needs to choose a doctrine. I mean, he's got enough time. He needs to make a decision. Choose something. All of these choices are reasonably well. In fact, I mean, one could get him T-30-45s, marked vehicle, Guards infantry, and mortars. One could get him, you know, the ISU-152, Guards infantry, bombing strikes. That would also be quite effective. Another, again, you know, the IS-2, shock troopers, or KV-8s. All of those would, you know, be viable choices for Heisenberg, but again, he needs to make a choice, and that's bloody well soon. Looking at Isundil, on the other hand, I mean, he's chosen Doctor, but he's not actually making much use of it. There's no mortar half-tank. I've so far yet to see any panzer tactician in usage, and I'm not, certainly not seeing, you know, L reconnaissance or the Tiger tank, though. That's obviously just only recently gotten available. The second Panzer Force on the way. He's got a replacement MD-42. That's good. But he needs to get a bit more on the grass on the defensive. Now he needs to sort of branch out into here. This sort of gives it a bit harder for him to sort of get the full advantage of his anti-tank, and also allows the enemy infantry and tanks to maneuver a bit more around. If he can sort of get out in the open and then sort of draw them in, that will definitely work out. He also needs to use the target weak point, you know, really, you know, stop one of those tanks right away and then follow up with a punishing blow from a Panzer IV. That way he might, you know, stand a chance, in particular with the second Panzer IV. He needs to get on the offensive. He needs to sort of attack and push back Heisenberg. He can't really afford now to sort of dither around on the defensive. He needs to show some true spirit of the Blitzkrieg. So that's something to keep in mind. In terms of damage, we can also see here that Isundil is actually doing a lot more, though. But again, that's also partly through the tanks. You know, again, tanks damage counts for a lot. In that regard, you know, at the same time, you know, Heisenberg's been so great at keeping them alive. So at the same time, while in that regard, you know, he's taking a lot of damage at the same time, it's not necessarily the most vital of damage he's suffering, though. Again, his infantry is suffering a bit, but at the same time, you know, so is Heisenberg. So, not all that bad. And again, you know, he's quicker to repair his repairs damage than Isundil is. And that's actually also important. And Isundil needs, at the very least, another Pioneer Squad to expedite repairs. One Pioneer Squad is simply not going to cut it. In particular, not when it has no veterancy. For that to even remotely work, it should have been veterancy too. It's not. So that's no good. But back to Heisenberg, back to the fight. And there we go again. Both units here on work on that T-34. And again, just flies away there. So good job there.
Our lines have been cut.
Your predecessor died a hero.
Ready for orders.
Looks like the Panzer Force ready to move out. Second Panzer Force arriving as well. Small duo. Strafniki engaging here, the Grenadiers. Veterancy 3 with a light machine gun. Also, oh, a light machine gun abandoned! Abandoned? You don't abandon an LMG! I mean, the Strafniki will definitely benefit from that. I mean, they're some of the units that actually get the most offensive veterancy of any infantry. I mean, they get accuracy bonuses both for levels. Plus, they shoot faster at level 2. So, I mean, getting this would be absolutely insane. They could really deliver a lot of damage with that MD-42. And there go Panzer Force bombarding the enemy infantry. And now we see him moving ahead. Good job, good job. Pack 40 should move out as well. T-34 blasting it. Close to veterancy 2. And there we go. Veterancy 2. Increased rate of fire, increased damage. Panzer 4 pulling back. They're heavily damaged, but close to Veterancy 2 itself and the Schützen. T-34 rolling back swiftly as the other Panzer IV advances. Conscript moving up to flank and get off an anti-tank grenade and connect. Damaging the engine, well done. But again, only one engineer to repair, or pioneers repair that Panzer IV compared to the T-34s again, which can expect both pioneer squads to get to work at one at a time. Nice penal battalion charge up the left flank. He's going to need to move in more troops to deal with that rather swiftly. The Panzer gunners will definitely be needed alongside some MG equipped grenadiers. And again, seize that MD-42, someone! MD-42 is ending up, but a bit too slow there. He realizes what's up and quickly pulls back. That was definitely a swift reaction there. And again, note, focusing on repairing that T-34. That one's repaired, but again, the other one's going to take some time before it's back in fight. And again, that's a Panzer IV, almost a Veterancy 2. That's hardly the most effective thing, Wes. Again, note, very soon Heisenberg has his Veteran 2 T-34 back on the field, ready to punish Isundil and the 23rd Panzer Division fascists. So it's definitely something there. It looks like, oh, he chose mechanized support. He might actually be going for an ISU-152 then. Oh boy. That's going to be fun. For the Russians, that is. For the Germans, it's going to be hell. Concentrating straight into the MG Grenadiers, and again, you know, that's definitely one of the advantages. And there you go, burning up.
Panzer IV ready.
And again, quickly pushing ahead with his repair T-34. The other one almost ready as well. I mean, he's been able to bring two T-34s into the time it took to get one Panzer IV ready. Again, it makes a massive difference how many engineers you actually have to work on that.
Panzer IV.
Massive.
Panzer IV ready.
Though so far then it seems like Heisenberg isn't taking full advantage of it, which is a bit of a shame in particular since this one is also close to Veterancy 2. I get the impression here that he might be setting up for some sort of Tiger move. And clearly, I mean, Heisenberg's going for the ISU-152, the Beast Killer Severo Boy. I hope I pronounced that reasonably correct. Known for knocking out heavy German armor, basically fusing only high explosive shells and the sheer concussive force of those. And there we go. Schwero boy here. That's definitely going to be unpleasant. Also quite effective against infantry overall. Very, very potent gun. I mean, very good against German armor, very good against German infantry. I mean, it's not quite as good against, I must say, the elephant, but that's exactly not something bad, since still, you know, it can easily take out a huge chunk of any German army. Just note here, one third of its health have gone. I mean, three shots, it can knock out any tank right there, getting down to almost half health. Don't underestimate the ISU-152, in particular since it does have a massive range. Focus out up there. T-34's not being used too aggressively then again. Right now the PAC-40 is right there, which couldn't, in theory, anyways, end up with it being targeted by the ISU-152 and blasted to bits. There we go, and he's actually coming under fire. First shot misses there. Come on, Yuri.
Ready.
Careful with the Grenadiers. And careful with that PAC-40. I really shouldn't be standing out in the open like that. At least use anti-tank gun ambush tactics. You know, remember, you have that ability at Veterans of Free for your PAC. And of course means, you know, they can't just, you know, shoot at you from afar, so use it. Panzer IV can repair, but again, happening slowly. There we go, finding a way there. Come on, pull either way of the PAC-40 away, or camouflage it, just do something, man. Infantry leading the assault, T-34's moving up. Come on, get the hit, Isundil. Get with the program. Panzer strikes out from the Panzer Grenadiere. ISU-152 continues to fire away. Panzer IV bombarding the advancing Strafniki. More to fire away. Panzer just really shouldn't be out in the open there. ISU-152 shooting away at the Panzer IV. Slight gap there, allowing it to do so. And again, he needs more pioneers. Panzer is moving ahead there, getting blasted by the T-34. Need to be careful again, remember, there's an ISU-152 out. Quick, get by the Ladno. Nice losses then, the conscripts.
We are ready.
Looks like he might be able to take back that MG-42. And there go T-34 again, ramming the Panzer IV. Crew shot, but not dead. A bit of a shame he actually used his Veterancy 2 T-34 for that. I think that was a bit reckless. And there we go, ISU-152 firing up. Needs to pull back that Panzer IV. Pop smoke and blitz. Pop smoke. Use it, man. Pop smoke. Come on, Isundil. Nebel. Fritz Nebel, Captain. And there we go, now the engine's destroyed. Oh dear, Isundil. Again, you know, you pull away your tanks when they're that close to the front line and you know your opponent can actually shoot at them. Now he popped smoke, but you know, the smoke's going to be gone before he even moved there. Not good. That was definitely a blunder there from Isundin. And I mean, I can't help but feel, you know, a lot of players beginning to use it a lot less, which is a bit of a shame. Again, it is quite a useful ability. So that was definitely poorly handled right there by Isundil, and again, needs more pioneers. Again, a Heisenberg quick to repair his T-34, MG-42 firing away, Panzer is moving up with Panzer Schrecks. Grenadiers getting quite the blast there from the Isu 152. Veterans won on that one. No support for the Panzer IV, not even moving up the MD-42 to cover it from infantry. French alarm there, striking off the anti-tank grenade, but that's about it. One more hit and that's good night. Panzer IV moving up support. There we go, Panzer IV, it's a combat loss. Definitely due to Isundil's blunder.
Yeah.
Getting close to being able to call in a Tiger tank, but really... I do feel the loss of that Veteran 2 Panzer IV was a massive loss. One which he can't really afford. Said he could have been useful with those two Panzer IVs, blitzkrieging and then flanking the ISU-152, but instead he keeps playing passively. ISU-152 continues to fire away. Pack 14 dire straits and then go cleared out. Again, camouflage could have helped him. Making progress up on the right flank about damn time though. Again, he should have done that much sooner. Again, now it's already, under the category too little too late. And everything else is collapsing under the heavy blows of the Soviet army. Panzergrenadiere need to get the hell out of there. Guard infantry have arrived. Panzergrenadiers wiped out. Panzer Trek dropped. Come on, Isundil. Tiger sent in from a nearby. Schwerer Panzer Abteilung, but will it be enough? Grenadiers, ow, half gone. That ISU-152 is just a killer. Nice mining there by Heisenberg, by the way. More Panzer Shrikes. Mine went off right there. Engine damage, Panzer still need to retreat. Come on, Isundil. Unit preservation. You seem to have panicked a bit. Main gun destroyed on the T-34. Now the squad of Panzer going to be wiped out. Another tragic loss. There we go, blitzing in to try and flank. A bit too late again. Should have been done with two Panzer IVs. Also exposes the rear, and we're seeing he's actually just moving it back. Veteran 2, lovely. Tiger tank hits the mine. Not sure why it went on such a far off front, but it was clear his target was the ISU-152 anyways. And they go buttoning up as well. Panzer IVs also there. This is just an absolute disaster for Isundil. And there we go, Panzer IV, a total combat loss. And that Tiger is just now an easy target for the ISU-152. Mines are really dangerous for the Germans since, again, once they lose mobility with a damaged engine, I mean, they become easy targets for the Soviet tank destroyers. And he doesn't even have the munitions for the smoke to get out of there. The situation is definitely getting very, very dangerous here for the 23rd Panzer Division. The assault has stalled and is running into his troops. T-34 moving in. Another mine. Heavy engine damage. Or was it just an anti-tank grenade? I don't know. And of course, we've got the ISU-152 firing away as well. There we go. Nice bit of nasty damage delivered on the Tiger tank. Back to Heisenberg. Almost Veteran T2. T-34 ramming and only shocking, but still, that's 5 more seconds where it's not moving, though the ISU-152 can get off another shot. And there we go, Veteran T2, greater accuracy, greater rate of fire. And there we go, the Beast Killer kills the Beast, it does its job. And of course moves on to kill fascists. Of the more squishy kind. More T-34s arriving. Well, that ISU-152 is definitely taking its toll on the Germans.
Enemy forces are neutralizing a sector.
The Russians did have a sort of more dedicated heavy tank, so that was the ISU-122, which basically about had the same gun as the IS-2. But was just, cheaper to make and sort of more with a tank destroyer profile. Canadius running into a bit of trouble. Continually mining throughout the match. Good there. Not taking chances. Another squad wiped out.
We are awaiting orders.
Another pair of all rolling up, but Isundil realizes the fight is lost and pulls back. A loss for Germany. A bit of a nasty fight here. Some good action, but again, you know, Isundil kept making small flaws here and here. The MD-42, again, running position was at the same time too passive in the long run. Failure to provide enough pioneers to keep his tanks properly repaired, which it meant they were out for too long periods of time. And, you know, just, you know, too much passive despite having lots of tanks with, you know, veterans, one who could have charged in, done a lot of damage. He didn't. He got too passive, in particular once the RG-152 arrived. And then when he came in, you know, to launch an attack, he for some reason sent his Tiger tank off on a huge detour without checking for any mines, which, of course, in short, he couldn't do anything afterwards. So in that regard, a few mistakes here on attacks on, basically, you know, just temperament for the match, whereas Heisenberg, you know, kept doing all right. He mined, you know, he made a few mistakes here and there, but again, the overall good use of penal troops, by the way, good use of conscripts, good use of mines, good use of tanks, good use of ISU-152. He could have had the doctrines out much earlier, he could have benefited from guards infantry earlier, and definitely might also have had some use from the marked vehicle, but overall, you know, nicely played. So, hope you enjoyed this match. If you learned a thing or two or three, if you did, why not subscribe, tell your friends. If you didn't, well, why not film? You know, to provide some feedback in the comments. This is Imperial Dane saying, you know, subscribe and share. And cheers.